Hi everyone, J7409 here with you. I've had to be away for most of the day. I had a doctor's appointment, but I knew that the National Weather Service would be putting out today, and also Colorado State University, what they thought the 2019 Atlantic hurricane season would be like. And sure enough, it's come out now, and I want to share it with you and compare it to what I thought. Okay, 2019 Atlantic hurricane season predicted to be slightly below average. So they're going with El Nino is going to make sure that it's going to be below average. Well, I hope they're right. I didn't say it was above average. What I want to do is co to compare and see. It just came out this morning. Here we go. They're having the big deal, and all the people are meeting together down at St. Padre Island, Texas, slightly below average. That is the forecast for the 2019 Atlantic hurricane season from Colorado State University. Okay, the doctor there presented the forecast for the upcoming hurricane season from the National Tropical Weather Conference in South Padre, Texas. Due to signals of El Nino, warmer water along the equatorial Pacific, a slightly below average season is expected for the Atlantic basin. All right, here we come. The first forecast of the season calls for. All right, they've got 13 named storms. I said 10 to 14 named storms. They've got 5 hurricanes. I said 4 to 6 hurricanes. They've got 2 major hurricanes, category 3 or higher. I said 2 to 4. So we'll see what happens. Now, the current forecast models are aggressive for extremely warm waters in the Caribbean during July, along with most of the tropical basin this season. While those conditions could fuel a more active season, El Nino signals have tamed the forecast. El Nino typically creates, here we go, like I was telling you guys, more wind shear and negative conditions to allow for tropical development. Now, there is still quite a bit of uncertainty in the forecast for the season. If El Nino does not continue through the summer, that could increase tropical activity toward the end of the season. Well, just like I said in that video yesterday, and I apologize for it being choppy and beepy, I don't know why it did it. Yes, the shear wind out to sea, out in the Atlantic, when these storms come off of Africa or wherever they may pop up, it's going to tear them apart, slow them down. They shouldn't amount to a whole lot. But if they happen to make it closer to the coastlines, or if one pops up just around the coastline, that's my point. Boom, it's going to blow up, and people are not going to have a lot of time to prepare for it. You know how often this has happened. Just think about it again. Remember, Irma hung out in the ocean for a long time. It kept getting a little stronger, but when it got closer to the coastline, that's when it got teetotally out of control. Same thing with Maria when it was approaching the coastline of Puerto Rico. And this nor'easter that we just had a few days ago, it was nothing but a rain shower in Florida, and when it got off my coast, it had hurricane strength winds in it. So that's my whole point, people. You need to prepare now, get everything ready. Maybe it will be a forecast that will be a little lower in storms. That's a great thing. I hope this is right. Slightly below average, because it only takes one. So I wanted to share this with you, compare what I thought might happen and what I still think may happen. So far as all of the storm totals itself, that's very hard to predict, but I wasn't that far off from what they had. But so far as storms popping up, just be prepared, folks. They might not look like much out in the ocean, but if they make it closer to a coastline, odds are they're going to blow up. So, with that all said and done, everybody, have a good day, a safe day, a blessed day. Peace, love, and kindness to all. Thanks so much for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. The next forecast that comes out will be on June 7th from these people, and I will be sure and share it with you. Have a great evening.